a barge with my sister, my horrible aunt, and even worse neighbours, the Grobblers.
Here, look, ain't that our new neighbour?
What's her name? Harmony.
They're pigs, okay, though. Hello, Grunter. How are you today?
You likes my pig, don't you?
Yes, Gus, just you I find disgusting.
Just catching a bit of supper for my Augustus and me. You're welcome to join us later, if you wish.
I wouldn't have thought anything could live in that water.
Well, it can't, that's why it's easy to catch.
Oh, no, not another right one, Dad.
You just scrape around on the bottom. It's amazing what you pull up. I save a fortune on footwear.
What's that?
It's a duck! A terrified duck!
Where are you going?
To look for it! Shoo! Hello. You don't need to be scared of Grunter. Hungry, eh? Hungry and scared. And you like standing in puddles. I'll call you Puddle Duck. And if you're still here tomorrow, I'll bring you some scraps from the cafe, okay? Now, would I lie to you? Persistent little tyke, aren't you? Come and meet my dopey sister. This is the cafe where we both work. She's easy to recognize. She's the one with the clear daylight between her two ears.
And you can get rid of that thing for starters. This is a vegetarian cafe.
Well, Puddle's not for tea. She's for intellectual stimulation after talking to you. Oh, here she comes. Inspector Glenda, Sherlock Moans, part-time plot. Are you all right?
These pugs will have to go.
But they can't. They're Dad's. We promised we'd look after them while he and Mum are away.
Well, you can look after them by throwing them overboard.
Aunt Glenda, I don't suppose by any chance you stopped off to buy some food. We've only got this cake.
Food just keeps disappearing from this place since you two came to stay.
Well, I'm starving, and if you don't start spending some of the money Dad gave you for food and stuff, I'm going to write to him and tell him what an ogre you are.
£250. That's all he gave me for the whole summer to feed two growing girls. And a duck? Harmony, here's £5. Go and get some chips to go with the cake.
Why me? Why not you or Melody?
Because you're the youngest.
And we've been working all day. And when you come back, you can do the washing up.
Hee hee. Go take a running jump, the both of you. I wish you'd just dropped through a hole in the boat. I wish you'd just...
What on earth was that?
I hate them. I don't want to be here. I want to be there with Mum and Dad. Curious little thing, aren't you? Great sign of intelligence, that. That wasn't there before. Go away, get lost, not your house. It looks like a child wrote it. Like someone wishes... Storms hit the boat all day. There was something very strange going on.
Please shut up.
Tried to hurt me.
Nice to meet you too. Who are you?
Who are you?
You're just a kid.
And you're just a sad loser, coming in here and scaring people like that. Get lost.
So it was you who wrote the message on my mirror, get lost?
Me? No, I don't know anything about that.
Melody, what is it? Is there a burglar? Don't worry, I'm here now. Harmony, it's your Auntie Glenda. I'm here. Keep calm. I'm coming in.
I'm fine. I'm just exploring.
At 2 o'clock in the morning? But what's going on in here? We've had thunder and lightning.
And hurricanes and snowstorms.
I'm fine. Just go back to bed. I'm coming in a minute.
Not in a minute. Now.
I can stay just for tonight. I'm coming. Until I decide what to do.
Next morning, I brought some breakfast for the mysterious stowaway.
You got quite an appetite for a midget, haven't you? Okay, where are you from?
The planet Dink.
Look, all I need to do is get my Aunt Glenda and she'll call all her police friends and then you're out of here in a flash.
No police, please, no police! Look, I'll tell you things. But can I trust you?
Depends.
On what?
And whether I can trust you.
Come on. Just don't tell the police about me. It's too difficult to explain. At least for now. I'll show you something, though. This is for my special things.
Life is full of surprises.
Go away!
Go on, shoo! It's your boat. Give it an ultimatum. Either it leaves me alone or you boot it in the canal.
Talking of ultimatums, either you or Harmony get rid of these plants or I'll boot them in the canal.
The Queen's nose. You must be seriously short of onions if you think I'm going to believe that. 10 wishes?
It's true.
Yeah, sure it is. And there are little fairies living in my armpits. Anyway, it's mine.
It's not. The coin's only here because of me.
Oh, la-di-da.
Look, that coin is mine by rights. My uncle gave it to me.
It's just 50p.
Right. Put it to the test. A day.
What do you mean?
If you're so sure it doesn't work, test it. Go on.
How?
You're a bit of a liar, aren't you?
No.
I see, you just told one. Rub the Queen's nose and wish that every single time you tell a lie, it'll give you some sort of sign. Go on, I dare you.
That's stupid.
You're just scared.
Oh, yeah. Watch me. I wish that every time I tell a lie, the Queen's nose will give some sort of a sign. Well, was that it? Big deal.
You wait. You'll see. What's your name?
Donald Duck.
Where do you live?
Toilet.
Who are your parents?
Minnie and Mickey Mouse. See? It's a load of rubbish. I told you.
Yes, Cole! A lizard, a lying lizard!
can do it again.
Harmony, please come and help.
Don't go away.
No. No, don't beat me like this. Harmony!
I suppose this is as good as anywhere. They're all going to die if we don't do something.
We could sell them in here.
Yeah, why not?
We could set up a stall next to Beryl.
Sell all sorts of stuff. A sort of garden centre. That's what Dad wanted. All right, you go and get the rest of the pounds.
Okay.
Harmony, Melody, come on.
Tell him I'm sick.
Yes.
Wait. Oh, no, not you. Go and squeeze your blackheads or wash your socks or something, Gus.
I ain't got none on. I've been squelching in the mud with Grandma, see?
How interesting. Now, can you leave me alone? I've got a lot on my mind at the moment.
You need a man to help you with all that gardening stuff. Someone like me. I could do the lifting and you can mend the holes in my vest.
What a ravishing thought, Gus.
There you are, Puddle. A nice carry cut for you. Now, don't tell Aunt Glenda.
Has anybody seen my tool bag? Harmony, what are you doing?
There's a mad strange child in the hold with a tongue half a metre long. I'm taking her some supper.
You have such a vivid imagination.
Yeah, well, it does help. Because if I try hard enough, I can imagine that Melody is almost human.
Ooh. That's my tool bag. Where are you?
Here.
You're gonna have to help. Careful. Careful.
It's grown. Should be interesting to see how someone with a tongue bigger than they are tries to eat. Or not. Want to try telling me the truth?
I am telling a quote.
Liar.
Look, the Queen's nose is just trying to tell you to cool it with the lies. At least to me. It knows me, don't you see?
What should I do?
What's your name?
My real name's Geraldine.
Gelatin?
Geraldine!
Geraldine!
Yes, but don't you dare ever call me that. Or I'll punch your face in. Call me... Dina.
Dina? Hey, I like it. Hi, kid. So, how long have you been here?
About 2 months.
Hey, look!
It's getting smaller!
The Queen's nose. It's had its fun. So, how old are you?
11.
Yes! Look!
Almost back to your old ugly self. So, where are you from?
I can't tell you. Not yet. Really, can't tell you.
Why not?
Trust me. I can't tell you.
Okay. We'll leave that for now. But look, you're back to normal. So where did you get the coin?
Well, it was here. I found it.
Weird. Why has it come back? And why show itself to you rather than to me?
Oh! This book. It came with it. It's rubbish, though. It's stuck. It won't open. I even tried with a chisel.
Hey, look. A book is living fair if you just unlock what's there. What's that mean?
Search me. I've never known a book have a life.
Well, it does, if you read properly and use your imagination. Maybe that's what unlock means.
Ah, yes. But maybe it just means this.
Where did you get that?
Well, I know it sounds stupid, but it just turned from my pocket. Honest.
It worked! Uncle Ginger! It's you!
Hello, Harmony.
Oh, it's great to see you. And to have the Queen's nose back. I can't wait to start wishing again.
Oh, but you can't.
Why not?
Only Dino can wish. Under your guidance.
But that's not fair. You gave the coin to me.
The concept of fairness, Harmony, is wishful thinking.
I don't understand. Why has it come back at all?
It has a purpose. Reconciliation, perhaps. Everything will unfold if we allow it.
I miss you.
I miss you too. Here.
Oh, wow!
Dina?
Uncle Ginger? Gone.
Well, you look sort of interesting.
The best.
So what now?
Well, you can stay. And tomorrow we'll introduce you to Auntie and Sissy.
And no police?
No police.
Great.
Oh, no! Where's Puddle? You stay here, in the hold, and on no accounts move, right?
Right.
Oh! Help! 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 Aunt Glenda! Arm yourself! Intruder! Glenda!
Call the police!
But you are the police! Puddle, where are you?
What are you doing? I told you to stay put.
I'm a free spirit.
No, you're not. You're a dipstick.
Look, I needed some fresh air, so I came out for a stroll.
You always take my sister's jewellery out for a stroll.
What?
And the rest.
I don't know what you're talking about. Hey! Well, how did that get in there?
It's a real mystery.
The mystery is how you thought you could get away with it. You're a liar and a tea leaf. Remember what happened to your tongue when you kept lying? Maybe you'll start again. Look, we had a deal and you broke it. Why?
I get these mad thoughts. I started to think that maybe you'd turn me over to the old Bill. I'd lost my hiding place. So I grabbed what I could and legged it.
Well, what are you running from?
Look, I can't tell you. And you said you wouldn't ask. You promised. Oh, Harmony, just give us a break. Don't grass me up. I'm a poor, misunderstood kid who just needs a second chance.
No, you're a dozy dimwit who needs a new brain. But you are right. You are just a kid. Look, I'll square things with my family and we'll introduce you properly tomorrow. Deal?
Deal.
Did you get a good look at this intruder?
Did he have the look of a nefarious villain?
Oh, what does nefarious mean?
Well, it means exactly what it means. No more, no less. Now, could you, let me see, could you...
Draw him?
Identify him.
Say what he looked like.
Well, it all happened so quickly.
Tall, short, thin, fat, dark, fair.
Yes, I think he was.
Yours, I believe. Mostly cheapo Christmas cracker stuff, but there you go.
Harmony, where did you find these?
More importantly, has anyone seen Puddle?
Where did you find this jewellery?
Outside. There was this bloke. He saw me, he panicked, and he must have dropped them.
Then what?
Well, then he legged it.
But why didn't you chase after
him? Glenda, please, could you let me handle this? Could you... could you say what he looked like?
Oh, well, he was tallish, he was bald, he had a red beard and a scar down his left cheek, and he had a limp.
What was he wearing?
Oh, jeans, denim jacket and bubble hat. How did you know he was bald if he was wearing a bubble hat? It fell off while he was running.
You said he had a limp. How did he run?
He ran with a limp.
You're lying.
And you're subhuman, but I don't go on about it.
Look, look, it's getting late. I suggest that first thing tomorrow I show Melody some mugshots and then see if she recognises anybody.
You took the very words out of my dentures, Glenda.
Morty! Who's the grubby-faced dwarf?
Oh, me, Dina.
Hi. I'm going down to the police station with Aunt Glenda after breakfast. Can you tell Fred I'll be late? Oh, and do try and sell a few plants.
Oh, yes, about that. Would you agree we could do with some business help?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Someone with a razor-sharp financial brain and full of ideas. I'm glad you agree. That's why I invited Gregory to join us on the Garden Centre project.
What? Gregory? Well, I thought you'd be pleased. You did used to go out with him. That's the problem. He'll still be madly in love with me, and I'd have to keep rejecting him, and it will all end in tears. Perhaps he's forgotten about you.
It doesn't work like that. I just seem to have this fatal attraction that just never dies. It's almost like magic. I just seem to charm boys.
Hello.
Crooksy! Oh, it's great to see you.
How are you? You've changed.
How?
I didn't realise how pretty you are. Sorry, it's just nice to see you.
A tea?
Didn't see you there behind the teapot. Hello, Melody. How are you?
Actually, I...
Anyway, Harmony, what have you been up to?
Well, this and that. This is Dina.
Hello, Dina.
She's a mutant. She can't speak, which is a blessing, really.
Melody? Has anyone seen Melody? Melody, it's time to go.
This is Dino and Gregory.
Oh, hello.
If you pass in the shop, will you get me some more of them biscuits?
What?
Two packets.
Shopping brings me out in a rash.
Oh, please.
Oh, all right. I'll get the float.
I thought you said Dino couldn't speak.
She learns quickly.
Oh, no. I don't believe it.
What?
The money your father gave me. It's gone. Our visitor last night was obviously more busy than we thought. Stupid of me not to have checked. Oh, it's not one thing, it's 20 others since you two came. Oh, I've got to go.
I swear it wasn't me. The jewellery, yes, the money, no. You've got to believe me.
Why should I?
Because I say so.
Well, that doesn't mean a whole pile of beans, does it? I mean, how do I know you haven't taken Puddle too and sold her to a butcher or swapped her for a packet of biscuits?
I come at a bad time.
What? Yes. No. Oh, I'll show you to the stall, the centre.
Can't wait. Even gave up my job.
What? Why?
Because you said it was a brilliant place. Large, immaculately decorated, huge staff. Sounds like the kind of business opportunity I couldn't afford to miss.
Right.
I want to cry.
You just need to use your imagination a bit.
Harmony, I gave up a perfectly good job to come and work in this... You lied to me.
Well, it's good to start from scratch.
This is not... Oh, what's the point? Let me see the accounts.
The accounts?
Yes, the accounts.
Oh, those accounts. there aren't any.
I see. What's capital have you got, you know, money?
None. Oh, are you all right?
I'm not going to get violent. I'm going to get going. Right. A workforce. That lot in there. They don't look too busy. Get them to look around for wood, glass, anything we can use. Tell them I'm from the Social Security, and if they don't do this community work, they'll lose their pensions. That should motivate them. I'm going to make some calls for cash.
Attaboy, Grogsy. With you in private.
What do you think you're playing at?
Cluedo? Badminton?
The games you're playing with Gregory.
What games?
Do you think I'm stupid or something?
If you don't fancy him anymore, then why are you in such a state?
You obviously have no understanding of emotions. I may not want him, but I don't want him to fancy anyone else. I don't want him back, but I want him to want me to want him back. And although I don't think of him as someone I fancy, I do think about him as someone whom I want to fancy me. So in that sense, I do think about him, without thinking about him. Do you see?
Yeah, it's as clear as mud. I suggest you lie down in a dark room in hope that your brain may grow.
And you can tell that little friend of yours to buy her own biscuits in future. Don't they feed her at home?
If only you knew.
This is it, Harmony. This is our big chance.
Oh, no.
Disaster. Complete disaster.
You sparingly. And we sloshed it on like gravy, didn't we?
Maybe I turned up the heating too much.
150 Fahrenheit. Gregory, these plants aren't just dead, they're microwaved. Look. This one survived.
Look, I'll go back to the bank and see what I can do.
Don't worry. You gave it your best shot.
Yeah, but it just wasn't good enough. Not now, Melody.
I think we need some sort of assistance. Something special.
No, why should I? You think I'm a liar and a thief.
I said I believe you. About the jewels, honest.
Yeah, what about Puddle? You don't still think I had anything to do with the going missing?
If you say so.
I'll prove it. In the meantime, I'll make the wish. Just this once. I wish the plant business would just grow and grow.
Thank you.
Gregory, what a surprise!
Yes. Well,
I just wanted to say, I hope you're not doing this garden centre thing because you hope that you and I...
Excuse me. Hello? Oh, Amanda. I really don't think you should say things like that down the phone, but it's very nice of you. I love you too. Ciao. Sorry, Melody, you were saying?
Eureka! Yes, yes, yes!
Go and wash in something antiseptic.
I want this plant thing punished. I want it shot and hung and chopped up. No!
Melody, work!
It worked! Gregory, it really worked!
The potential, the publicity, the profit.
It's licorice.
We've got work to do. This isn't just going to be a garden centre. It's going to be a theme park.
Mm. Now, Puddle.
I think you're fat enough now. Like a roly-poly Christmas pudding. Be a nice surprise for Dad. Duck and chips with brown sauce.
Gus Grobler, I want a word with you. I know you're in that smelly old shed. And I know you've got Puddle. Gus Grobler!
When I get hold of you, you're dead.
When I get hold of you, you're dead. I wish that something will happen to Gus Guttrop Grobler to make him well sorry he took Puddle.
Everybody this way to the Green Fingers theme park tour!
This, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, is our edible area. Here we have the jelly worm plant. You'd like to sample some of that? Nice. Here, ladies and gentlemen, is our very own incredible kissing plant. And if that gentleman there would like to step forward, you'll soon see why. Go on, sir, don't be shy.
Oh! Saucy plant!
And here, a personal favourite of mine, the coral plant. Business can be a very creative thing, you know, almost like magic.
Monthly freshen up.
Look.
So where was she?
Gus had her. It's all sorted out now. So now do you believe me?
Sure.
And about the money?
I told you. I don't believe he took the money.
Thanks. How's the business going?
Oh, Gregory's been on such a It's another one. Oh, is everything all right?
Not sure. You better open up.
The plants have gone mad. Run for your life.
Linda. Could I have a word?
Oh, please.
Sir. What seems to be the trouble?
Everybody stop running around! Stop panicking!
Stop it!
Everybody.
I'm an officer of the law, and if you don't stop it at once, I'll arrest the lot of you! Right! Hose pipe for you lot!
Everybody, Dad.
Right.
Get up.
I think I handled all that rather well.
Well, we've still got the bank loan. Maybe we should expand. A market area.
Yeah.
Spread to other projects. A children's play area. A big sign. Gregory's Garden Gala.
What are you, Dad?
What are you wearing?
Not wearing more like.
Glenda.
Gregory, we really need to talk.
You
see, I know how you feel, and... As I was saying... I know how you feel.
About what?
Well, I know you like this perfume, this type of
clothes. No, not anymore. You see, I realised that the kind of girl I really like is natural, you know? Dressed in something a bit more feminine.
I'll go out with you if you like.
What do you want?
Oh, sorry, missy, but my Gus here is in real trouble, and I reckon you lot have got something to do with it.
Why has he got that stupid bin on his head? Not that I'm complaining. Oh!
Oh, I think I'm going to be sick.
Oh, you likes it then?
No!
Oh, you see, it's my problem.
Oh, what's up?
I know it's inhuman, but I can't bear to look at it.
He started to say something about a curse from over here. I was wondering if you knew anything.
No. Harmony?
Not me. Though I'd say it's an improvement rather than a curse. Nothing to do with us. Unless...
What? Why are you looking at me?
A word in private, Dino. Come on.
All right, so what? I said I'd do it and I did it. He deserves it.
Okay, and it was hilarious, but you've got to change him back now.
Waste my fourth wish on that puss bag? No way.
You've got to.
Are you sure this is absolutely necessary?
Absolutely. Otherwise, people will start asking questions, snooping around, and before you know it, you've lost the Queen's nose.
It's gone.
What? Stop messing about, Dino.
Actually, it's gone. The Queen's nose. It's lost.
Come on, look. It must be here somewhere, Dino. These are yours, are they?
So what if they are?
What on earth have
Look,
you...
Look, I used to have to wear them when...
When what?
Nothing. Put them back.
What else is in here?
Look, I said leave off. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Yes. Puddle, listen. The Queen's nose. Did you swallow it?
Oh, no.
Yes, growing like the plants.
Gregory, I've decided to forgive you.
Oh, thanks.
Well, am I feminine enough for you? Were you listening?
Of course. You said, what did he say?
Dino! Action station! Puddle alert!
Has she,
not yet. I think we're about to have liftoff. The Queen's nose is hopefully in motion.
Well, there it is.
Funny old colour.
Right.
Definitely not.
What not?
Right. Now wish.
I wish that Gus will return to normal.
Well then.
I was getting fed up with being Gregory's assistant, so I decided to start up a business of my own. There you go.
It's not fair.
And I sent Dino off to do Gregory's chores.
Harmony, I need you to look after the store while I take the cash.
How am I meant to run two businesses at once? I'm telling you, therapy is a growth industry, Gregory.
I believe it when I see it. Excuse me, please.
What did I tell you?
Are you the therapist?
I am.
Just step into my consulting room.
Beautiful.
Karen.
Yes, but she's lost her appetite for reciting. I wonder if you can help.
Oh, let's see, shall we?
If you could all form an orderly queue outside.
Oh, sorry.
Oh. I'm starving. I need a tea break.
No.
Who do they think they are? Making me shovel 50 pounds of food from one place to another. Why can't they do it? In fact, they'll get their paunchy little hands all smelly. Anyway, I can eat what I like when I like. I've got the Queen's nose. Stop the rest.
Hey, you haven't finished yet?
What a bet!
Gregory, I was wondering if you wanted any help.
I'll do anything.
Right. We can start off by shoveling that pile of dung there.
Oh.
Oh, no. Excuse me. I need to go to the bathroom. I wonder if you could look after Herman here. Oh, and save my space in the queue. He gets a little bit over-affectionate sometimes, so don't let him get carried away, will you? Thanks.
Who do they think they are? Tea break.
You obviously hit it off. Wasn't too frisky for you, was he? Oh, he looks a lot better now. Thanks, cheers.
Are you feeling better, Melody? Strange girl. I tried to cheer her up, but she just seems to get more depressed. There's no pleasing some people. Excellent. Sometimes a shock does the trick.
Oh, look at this.
She's just the same, only wet.
I'm stuffed. What's going on? Stop it! It's not funny. Pack it in. I was hungry, that's all.
Have you tried her slapping around the face?
No, that's no good. Dangle a poisonous spider in front of her face. That'll soon wake her ideas up.
Chuck her in the canal.
Well, what's up with her?
Comatose. There's been nothing happening from the neck up.
Well, that's normal. This is something else.
Harmony, do something. She's your sister.
Yeah, bad luck.
This is very bad for business.
Actually, Gus.
What?
You know how you like my sister?
Yeah, so what if I do, eh?
Do you believe that men should be strong and assertive?
Yeah. What's assertive?
It means you should be the boss, a sort of caveman type.
Oh, but I live in a caravan.
I know you do. Okay, let's make this simple, like you.
Oh.
Do you want to kiss Melody?
I suppose so.
Well, go on then.
Right.
Melody, Gus Grobler is about to plant one fat, wet, slobbery kiss right on your lips. Ah! Oh, oh no, what happened?
You're all right now.
I had this feeling someone was going to kiss me. Gregory, you do care.
No. You see, you got it all wrong. It was
I was just passing your boat, and that's when I saw them.
So what?
Well, I was just about to step on board. It was 3:33, precisely. Yeah, no, look, I've made a note of it. Look, 3:33. Anyway. Well, how can I put it? I mean, well, it was a sort of
intruder again.
No, more of
a dead body floating.
No, an explosion.
No, let's go. We'll be here forever
otherwise. Oh my giddy aunt.
Get down! Back! What is going on?
Look, don't blame me. Just grab a weapon.
Are you seriously trying to tell me you had nothing to do with this?
No, I didn't say that. I just said it wasn't my fault.
You made a wish, didn't you?
So? It's my coin.
Well, what did you wish for?
Yes.
Spaghetti?
Oh, it's no use. There's more and more of the stuff.
We need help.
Where's the book? In my room, I think.
Let's get it. Go that way. Quick.
Harmony.
Uncle Ginger, you've got to help quickly.
Rush. How can you think when you're hurrying everywhere?
But Dino's gone.
Yes.
She wished for spaghetti. She's greedy, monumentally greedy.
Yes. So maybe unselfishness will help free her. That's where you come in.
I was afraid of that. But how can I find her?
What does spaghetti remind you of?
Knitting, worms, snakes, string, rope.
Yes. And what would be useful on a rescue attempt?
Rope.
Yes.
So greedy. I promise to share all my Garibaldi biscuits with you. I promise to help clean the centre without moaning.
Come on, let's go home.
Where are you going?
I'm leaving. But this is your home.
Sort of.
Yeah, and I hope it sinks. I'm off. For good.
I didn't get rid of her that easily. A few hours later, she was back. I pretended not to notice.
What are you doing?
Setting up as a car mechanic. Thought I might as well face the punters that come into your theme park.
Didn't know you knew anything about cars.
Nothing to know. You just open the bonnet and say, don't like the look of that, mate. Cost you a fortune in labour. And then there's the parts, difficult to get. And then you fiddle around a bit and charge hundreds of pounds.
Isn't anyone glad I'm back?
Of course we are. We were worried sick, weren't we, Harmony?
Yeah, if you say so. Yeah.
I got to thinking, and it didn't seem fair to leave you. I mean, I know you couldn't cope without me. And once I get a glamorous, well-paid job, I'll be able to help you all even more. Especially now we've both been fired from the CAF. I've already applied for one. In a recording studio, as an operations executive.
You're not still here. Harmony!
Hello, Greenfingers. Yes, we have just opened a children's play centre. Yes, we do take orders. 12 dozen bottles of Scottish Glen. Okay.
Get this down.
10 CDs. Okay. Bye.
Oh, there's a weirdo at the boat asking for you, Mel.
Sounds like a right turnip.
That'll be box number 352. He answered my ad and I told him to come here. Oh, I hope he's a dish and rich.
What ad?
Well, I decided if I was going to start a new life, I needed a new boyfriend, so I put an ad in the personal column.
What did you ask for?
Oh, a well-built, sensitive, wildly attractive, incredibly rich businessman.
Hey! How you hanging, babe? I'm your main man, box 352. Name's Animal. You want to come missing for some kissing? Chugging for a hugging. And we can cruise with the news that I'm your number one dude. Give me a little lip locker. A little feast with the beast. What do you say?
I don't know what you're talking about. Would you go away, please?
That's cool, too. Like I'm already gone. Hey.
I've come to answer your watch it, your ad do free, to be your boyfriend and snug you. I got you a cauliflower. Needs washing a bit. I think there might even be a caterpillar in it. Anyway, how about it then?
I'd rather have my head cut off than go out with you.
If you don't go out with me, I'll blow up your theme park.
You need help.
Yeah, my fee, yeah. 5k. That's it. Yeah, I've got to go. Mustache. I couldn't resist that. I'm a fashion photographer, see? And I was just on the phone to one of my editors saying that whenever I see a glamorous girl who should be the next Naomi Campbell, I'll just have to shoot.
Better and better. Melody.
Strong. Rod Strong.
There's no business like show business. Da, 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 da.
What are you doing?
What do you think? I'm dancing.
Dancing?
Actually, it's flipping hard work. Especially when you're as good as I am. More important, have you squared things with your aunt for me yet? So that I can stay?
It's difficult, because when I tell her you live here, she thinks I'm joking. But I'll work on her, if you do something for me.
What?
Well, I got this card from Mum and Dad.
Melody wrote to them and told them how miserable she's been. And they want me to be nice to her.
So, what's that got to do with me?
I'd like you to use the Queen's nose to wish her success.
Give me 2 quid as well and you're on.
The Queen's nose isn't a business, Dino.
Oh, I'm sure Her Majesty's conk won't object if I make a few bob on the side.
2 quid.
Ooh, the sweet jingle of unearned dosh. Nothing like it.
You sad little dust mite.
Okay. I wish that Melody has some success.
Yeah, it might help if you meant it. Now look what's happened. You may put M in the frame, but mistakes lead to uncertain games. A lark not a peacock may be the way. This wish decides to make matters pay.
Brain wobbler.
M must be Melody. In the frame.
Door, windows, pictures?
Yes, photographs! Something to do with rods. Mistakes and uncertain games. Sound both good and bad. Things often do with the Queen's nose.
Chin up. Oh, you're so gorgeous. Chin up, always chin up. Fantastic.
Hello!
I do hope you can bring out the inner me, you know, very deep and soulful. You know, a bit of Madonna, Inner Vita, all the Spice Girls and something a bit different. I don't know, the Pope or something.
Oh, I'll do my best. Now give me that heart-stopping, mouth-watering smile of yours.
This one?
That's the one?
Not believe this. My turn to clean.
So, when will these be published, Rod?
Pretty soon.
And when will I get paid?
As soon as they're published.
I can't wait.
Well, this isn't working. We need a different background, something more natural.
Oh, well, why don't you try the garden centre? She'd fit in well with the creepers.
Fantastic. Oh, wow.
Can't you go and play with your new boyfriend?
It's funny. Roxy should be here. He's normally at work by sunrise.
Hello.
Who is that?
Go away.
Roxy, is that you?
Allegedly.
What happened?
I don't know. But if it's anyone's fault, I'm going to kill them.
Gregory!
Oh, stop gawking at me like that.
Oh, blimey.
Douch! Get off! You've got a great address. Some skimpy little number.
Yes.
No, I will not be seen like this.
Let's dress him up.
No, please. This is not fair. Harmony, please. Get off of me.
This is fantastic. Let's Gregory, listen to me back. I'm just letting your teeth. What a fine.
All right, joke's over. Give me them back.
Okay, sissy. Give Gregory back his trousers.
Soft spot for Gregory, huh?
The only soft spot around here is your head. Now give Gregory back the trousers. Fine.
And what are you laughing at?
You? Got a problem with that, have you?
Yes.
What are you going to do about it?
You broke, you killed him!
Roxy!
Oh, my poor baby! You will remember to take my photographs to the editors tomorrow, won't you?
Yes, of course!
This arrived for you. Somebody's already opened it.
Yeah.
Congratulations. It is our pleasure to inform you that your job application at Meltdown Recording Studio has been accepted. Brilliant. I can be a top model and an operations executive at a recording studio. This is it. A top executive.
Go on, good luck, sis.
Hello?
Hello!
Oh dear, not you.
cool. Like you change your mind. Like it's destiny for us to hang loose together.
I'm afraid not. It's just I've been offered this top job, operations executive.
This is it. Everything begins here.
Oh, you mean I'm a cleaner?
Hey, there's worse things. Like you could die and come back as a lampshade.
I think Rodders has been telling Porky.
Rod, she's just popped to the shop. Care to join me?
Yeah? Thanks.
Tea? Fruit juice?
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, whatever. Coming straight at you. Good day.
Yeah.
Take many photographs, sugar?
Yeah.
Use up a whole toilet roll. Film roll. Milk?
What?
How does the advert go? Soft as a baby's doodah. Cake?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, yes, you do. And if you don't tell Melody, I will.
You know when I said that I was a fashion photographer? Well, what I meant was I'm sort of an apprentice, really. Well, I'm not actually employed as a fashion photographer.
What he's trying to say is he works in a bog roll factory delivering bog rolls.
All right, I can tell her.
It isn't true.
It is.
And the photographs aren't going to appear in all the glossies.
Well, I've sent them off to the editor of Reflections.
How wonderful. You sent them off. Well, everything's all right then, isn't it? And meanwhile, I have to work in that stinking hole of a recording studio and the theme park and the housework. You are a real toad.
You go for it, Sissy.
A slime bag.
Oh. A foil on the backside of humanity.
Beneath contempt.
A veruca.
A bit of fluffy dirt between toes. A lying snake.
Manipulative bird. A crab-faced codpiece.
There's something else. My name isn't Rod Strong. It's Horace Winthrop. Yes? What? Is this a joke? No, no. Yes. Yes, of course. That was Amanda Gladbanger, the editor of Reflections. She loves the photographs and wants to do a deal with me and the model.
Reflections! But that's one of the top magazines!
We've cracked it!
Well, when's she coming?
Tomorrow, first thing to the centre.
Ah, tomorrow! Makeup, camera, action!
I've got to wash my jeans, put some professional scuffs on my leather jacket.
No! Get Glenda at your service.
Yep, park her up, please. Hi, you must be Rod.
Strong.
Oh, I'm sure you are.
And this is Melody.
Hello. And this is my little sister. I'm afraid they'd run out of dress sense by the time they got to her. I was worried that I might look, you know, too innocent, too young. But I'm obviously just what you're looking for.
I'll come straight to the point. I'll pay £3,000 for a series of shots of the model. That face and figure, it's just what we're looking for.
Yes, yes, yes. Where do I sign?
I'm sorry.
I have a contract.
I think there's been some misunderstanding. You are the photographer, right?
Right.
And this is the model we're talking about.
Oh, no, no. I forgot. They're on the same rule.
Gregory!
What?
She's the one. I'm going to make you a star, sweetie.
Oh, I can't bear!
You're even more charismatic in real life. A touch of Bardot, an insouciant sprinkling of Baywatch bimbo in conflict with enigmatic depths. You're a mystery. I could eat you. What's your name?
Gregory.
No, seriously, I bet it's Terry Spice.
No, my name is Gregory and I'm a bloke. M-A-L-E. Masculine. Fella. Chap. Mr. Monsieur. Senior. Gaffer. Geezer. Got it?
A sense of humour too. I love it. Make that £4,000.
Oh, I can't bear it. I'm going to work. And I never want to see you again. Horace.
You could be a millionaire inside 12 months, sweetie, I guarantee it.
I'm not your sweetie. My name is Gregory. I'm a bloke. I work here. All this hair and stuff is a mistake.
A mistake? No, it's not.
Oh. Such animal aggression in a young girl. If we could market that, well, then we're made.
Harmony, tell her.
He is a bloke. A guy, really.
No way.
Right. I'll prove it to you.
little time wasters.
Gregory, what did you show her?
What? Oh, season ticket. She's got my name and photo in.
Don't you wanna dream with me? Don't you wanna dream?
Okay, man. Like it's not happening. Like that was take 27, 37. Look, numbers ain't my strong point, but it's a waste of time.
What's up?
Oh, like BJ's up. Now he finally gets a spot on a TV special to plug his new song. But the girl singer hasn't shown.
Well, I could do it. I mean, I've heard you rehearse the song. I think I know the female part.
We ain't got none to lose but our heads.
Doing all right. I'm traveling light, so don't push me. It was easier when I was on my own, so don't push me. Don't want a home that's a battleground, so don't push me.
Today is the most wonderful day of my life.
You found your brain.
I've sung on a record and I'm going to be on a telly special to promote it. I can't believe it. It's a dream come true.
Now I get it.
Get what?
The rhyme. You may put M in the frame, but mistakes lead to uncertain gains. A lark, not a peacock, may be the way. This wish decides to make matters pay. And a lark is a songbird. The Queen's nose decided to help you in that way instead of a flashy model, which is a peacock. And I guess it used Gregory to make sure the modelling job didn't work out. Thank goodness he's back to normal now. Do you understand?
No, I couldn't care less. Come on.
Night, Gregory.
Night. I warned her. I told her I'd do it. I warned her. Now I'm gonna do it. I don't care what happens.
That was like the end of the world.
What was it?
It was the centre.
I'll get the police. Gregory!
Oh, dear, dear. Look at the state of you. Hang on, thank you. I'll get the worst.
Gregory! Gregory! Gregory, are you all right?
Well, I was until someone threw a bucket of water over me.
I was so worried.
Were you?
I thought you might be.
Oh, so did I.
Gregory! Oh, my poor baby! Oh, Lido!
I'm here! Glenda's here!
What happened? Is he all right?
What is it?
An explosive device.
Well, how do you know?
Trained eye. Sharp as a hawk.
You mean somebody did this deliberately?
I bet someone else's life on it.
There, my little babies. You should have seen the explosion. Boom! Beautiful. Magic.
Gus. Oh, the last time that you changed your underpants was when they invented the wheel. Do you know, your ears remind me of garage doors. What's up? Your brain turned back into the cow poop was in the first place!
Ugh!
Hello, Grunter. I've got the evidence. It was Gus. Aunt Glenda! Aunt Glenda, it's him!
Who's him?
It's Gus! He blew up the centre. I found all this in his shed. Gus deserves everything he gets. He just...
What are you looking at?
Nothing. Just a photo. Let me see. This is me. These are my mum and dad. They died in a car crash. I don't know who those two girls are. I don't understand. How did you get one?
I've always had it. Look again at the photo. This is me, aged 3 and a bit, and this is Melody.
Melody.
Sally?
But were you given another name after your parents died?
I was only little. Maybe. I don't know.
Don't you see? We're cousins.
I really do have family. Oh, I really do.
Look. See? Now I know why the Queen's nose led you here. To be reunited with your family.
Like me and Harmony. Mr. Grobbler, Gus and Grunter. They're a weird one, but I can't let them be split up. Gus and his dad were a right pair of old donkeys, and I know I only have 4 wishes left. But I wish that Glenda and Melody will love them, big time, so that all this police stuff gets dropped. Don't want them snooping about my life. They might find out that... Is that clear? Blimey.
Mr. Grobbler? Mr. Grobbler?
You come for my boy, have you? Yeah, he's in there.
I mean, Shearer was fantastic when he came round the right one there. Was...
Right, you can sweep now. Get back to work. Are you going to help or just stand there like a tent peg in half a frock?
I'm an artist. I can't possibly do menial chores like that now. I mean, the cleaning floor will play havoc with my voice. It's an enormous pressure looking after a talent like mine.
It must be an enormous pressure being a prat like you.
Have you seen Auntie Glenda? She's supposed to be taking me to the station. I've got a recording session at 12. I'll be late if she doesn't hurry.
She's still over at the Grobblers.
But she's been there for hours. I thought she was just going to collect gas.
More brown sauce, my love.
Just a smidge in my little fairy lamp.
Oh, you are a gorgeous! The wind just pours out of you.
Oh, better out than in, I always say.
Stop it, my jaws are aching from laughing.
How can you? He's gross. I can smell him from here. He's... A dream come true. Gus, darling.
What's that?
This is it.
What?
Nothing will ever be the same after this moment. Oh, please don't let this be a mirage, an illusion. Gus, say you're real.
Hello, Granta. What's the matter?
Oh, no. You are the daisy of my life.
Oh, Glenda, what is happening?
It's a miracle! The scales have fallen from my eyes. Why didn't anyone tell me what a wonderful man George is?
You do remember you were taking Gus down to the police station. I mean, that was the whole purpose of going over there.
Dear, sweet little Gus. Fruit of my love bug's loins. Yeah. Oh, and what's him nicked? All children are wonderful.
Including Dino. I hope so, because she's our cousin. The fruit of your sister's loins. Your niece.
Really? Wonderful. Yeah. Everything is wonderful.
You.
You look different.
I want to please you, my cherry bun. I know you like filthy clothes and dirt, and if that's what my love wants, that's what he shall have.
This must be some kind of joke.
Oh, I didn't do it as a joke.
So it was you wishing. I knew it was. But if Melody doesn't get a move on, she's going to miss her chance of becoming a pop singer.
I didn't realise it would be like this.
You thought wishing they'd fall in love would solve all their problems?
Yes.
You sure you didn't mean just your problems? Like having to talk to the police?
It's been easy for you all along. I wish someone there to look after you. Oh, is someone there to care for you? You act like Miss Cool Rebel Harmony. But it don't mean nothing because you've never really been out there on your own.
Oh, all right, cool down. But given that you've made two monsters and turned Aunt Glenda and Melody into dribbling little daisies, what are you going to do about it?
No way. I'm not wasting another wish on them.
Okay, well, you can go right back to where you came from. I don't want you as a cousin.
Oh, but I'd only have three left.
Well, that's your problem. You're such a dipstick. You've been wasting them.
Okay. £4.
Forget it.
I wish that those disgusting grobblers, Melody and Glenda, will all fall out of love.
Uncle Ginger, how did you get up there?
I don't know. I'm still trying to work it out.
Cool.
I assume this isn't a social visit.
No. Dino, really mean your wishes. And use your sense. Think, but not necessarily in a straight line. Things don't always go from A to B to C to D. Here, this might help.
Richard Elborg is a strange name. Say it shortly, thrice to change. But transformations are nasty tricks. Find a final cure in Follicks.
What's that supposed to mean?
Search me. The Queen's nose never makes things easy. But like Ginger said, you've got to mean it, Dino.
We're getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are going to chime. Girls, come and kiss me.
Say that you miss me, but
get me to the church on time.
If anyone sees me in this dress and laughs, I'm going to personally decapitate them.
I'd rather chop their heads off.
Okay, the riddle. Richard Elborg is a strange name. Say it shortly, thrice to change.
You ever heard of him?
No. But thrice means three times.
Richard Elborg, Richard Elborg, Richard Elborg.
Nothing. It says, say it shortly. But what does that mean?
I don't know.
Dino, we have got to work this out. Imagine if they get married. Life's just going to be a nightmare.
Don't say, get me to the church. Oh, John.
Yeah, well, cough it out then, son. Give it a good go. See, that's what I do to clear the old tubes out, you know.
Oh, manners, George.
Is that... is it a...
He's my best man, Gunter Grobler. It's a he. He's going on the honeymoon.
Really? This place in which you are now met has been duly sanctioned for the celebration of marriages. Now, I have your names here somewhere. Will you please stand?
Aina Winkle. That's it. How do you shorten a name? You abbreviate the first name to a letter. So Richard Elborg is...
R. Elborg.
Yes, or Relborg, which is the backwards name for Grobler. That's what Uncle Ginger meant when he said don't think in ABC terms. Think backwards. That must be it.
So have a go then. Say it three times.
Relborg, Relborg, Relborg! Well, something happened. Come on, Dino.
Right, the second part of the riddle. Transformations are nasty tricks. So find a final cure in... Follicks. Lowly? Well, is that a proper word?
No, I looked it up. Maybe you have to look carefully.
carefully. Oh, I know the Queen's nose will help us find the answer.
I do solemnly declare.
I like salmon and eclairs.
That I know not of any...
That's it! What? One, two, three, four, in Roman numerals. It's not volix, it's volume 9. One followed by X is 9.
But volume 9 of what?
I don't know, but I'm sure going to find out. You stall them.
How?
I don't know, just do it. But...
Library? That way.
Sorry. Return box. Volume 9. Transformations. People into animals, insects, objects. Animals, page 13. And one of O. Reinstate the status quo.
Now the solemn moment has come for these four persons to contract their marriage before you, their witness. Does the best man have the rings?
But you can't! Lena, what are you doing?
I got rhythm! I got music.
I've got the ring.
Yeah, but we got rhythm.
Oh, no. Catch me if you can.
After two of H and one of O. Two of H and one of O. Two of H and one of O. H2O. Water.
Now the solemn moment has come. Again, please, no more interruptions.
Stop!
Oh, not you two! You're spoiling my special day!
Watch and wait! The water!
What? Get the water! Copy me! Relborg! 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 Relborg!
Yes! It worked!
Oh, you're all mad!
And get off these clothes.
Good job I worked out for you, though.
You'd have been lost without me.
Yeah, dream on.
And I've been lost without you, but not for much longer.
Hey, Jellybean.
I did it all myself. I suppose Uncle Ginger helped a bit. What's up?
He was there. He just disappeared. Oh, I can't bear it, Harmony.
There wasn't anybody there.
There was. He's like that. Slippery as chipbats.
So who was he?
I've been trying to tell you, but you haven't listened.
So is it going to be the truth this time?
When is it anything but? Look, Harmony, you've got to help me. Please.
His name's Daniel Block, and he's a psycho. It's the bloke in Glenda's photographs. The bloke she's after. And I'm pretty certain it's him that took the money.
So how come you know it?
Okay. He was my guardian. He told me all my family were dead.
Which he knew was untrue.
Right. He used me and a few other kids in stuff like burglaries. Busking, shoplifting, scams in shops. You know, stuff like that.
So you really are a criminal? The question is, what we do now?
Murder! We could buy a cricket bat and whack him!
Very subtle. Let's think about it tonight and talk to Aunt Glenda tomorrow.
Harmony!
Puddle! Naughty.
Harmony, I want to talk to you about recent events, like weddings and donkeys. Harmony!
Gregory! Why on earth are you wearing that thing on your head?
I can't say just now. It's at a highly experimental stage. But are there things flying around my head? Mosquitoes, wasps, midges, that sort of thing?
Hello, Jellybean.
You? How did you get in?
Well, a boring question. Living all soft with these people must have taken the edge off you. We'll soon have you sharpened up when you're back with me.
I'm never coming back with you. Not ever.
Really? You forget you have a past. Meet me tonight by the canal bridge. 8 o'clock sharp.
Aunt Glenda's on the warpath. She's just...
What's up?
Look, the...
Well, he was just here!
What did he say?
I can't tell you. You don't know the trouble he can cause.
You've got to trust me.
I do. Honest. Tim, I don't trust. And I don't want to drag you into my problems. I'll handle it on my own.
You're making a big mistake.
I'll be leaving tomorrow. And I won't be taking the Queen's nose or the book with me. It belongs to my life here. And now it's finished.
I just had this funny feeling she was lying and that she planned to do a runner.
Mom! What are you doing? I said I'm handling this on my own.
Well, you also said you were leaving tomorrow.
Get lost.
No way, I'm coming with you.
Listen, I don't want you around, get it? You're different to me. With your poncy voice, and your family, and all the things you own. That's your world. Mine's different. And I don't need you in it.
Well, too bad, because you're stuck with me. We're cousins, Dino, and I'm not letting you go back unless you agree to my plan.
Brilliant. Did it occur to you that this man, Block, is dangerous? My information suggests he's potentially violent. Dino could be in real danger. And how would we know?
Time to rock and roll, Jellybean.
What you're doing.
Here, let me help.
I'm sorry. I'm just a bit rusty.
I think it passed through your mind to blow the whistle. I think you were tempted to shot me after all we've been through together.
I wasn't.
Yeah. I'm your family, Jellybean. I'm all you've got.
I've got friends and family.
What, those Parker people? Wake up. They were just using you to get to me.
Oh, yeah!
You didn't really think it was because of you, did you? Some inequality, some little bit of stardust they saw in you? Oh, no. At least with me, you know where you stand. Now then, to business. You are going to tell me a few things.
Like what?
The Queen's nose.
The trouble is, I can't actually use the Queen's nose to wish myself. So it might have been better if Dino had taken it.
Eureka!
Grogsy, what are you doing?
It works. I knew it would with a few adjustments.
You look as if they were trying to eat your head alive.
Keeping insects off our plants and tails a little pain.
Phew. Let me get this straight. You designed some weird sort of contraption to encourage insects to come and bite you.
Yes. Brilliant, eh?
No. Deeply sad and stupid.
Look, I've even refined it to this miniature version. Hello? Dino, where are you?
Here, give it to me. Where are you? Right? Well, what's happening?
He wants me to steal the Queen's nose. Oh, he says it can come back to you in return. Yeah, I've agreed. Tonight! Okay.
Jellybean?
Look, I've got to go.
Now, here's the Queen's nose. The deal is, you give him the coin, and he lets you come back here with no hassle.
Which you won't keep to, of course.
Of course not.
Well, Aunt Glenda's arranged for a plainclothes policeman to follow you, if he doesn't let you go. Then we can get him for theft and kidnap. And we'll be waiting for a message from either you or the policeman.
You don't know what he's like. I could do with some sort of tracking device too. You know, like a transmitter or something.
You mean something like this?
Grogsy, that's for attracting insects.
Well, it's better than nothing.
Now, can I go?
Of course.
Not. You didn't really think I'd let you go, did you?
But you're a good little puppy dog who always does what Papa says.
Let's go.
Look, this isn't the way back to the warehouse.
The secret of my success is movement. We'll hold up here until morning.
Then what?
Then we leave. I think it's time to set up somewhere new. Maybe abroad. Yeah. But we'll be together, so you won't be needing this.
What?
Now then, what's your cousin's name? Harmony. Yes, Harmony.
What about her?
Dino wishes that Harmony Parker be destroyed by, let's see, earth, air, fire, water. Yeah, fire,
no!
Water. There. Let's hope it works, eh? Come on, let's get comfy before it gets dark.
They are not coming, Gregory.
No, I think you're right.
Well, Dino said he's clever. He must have some idea he's being followed.
Whatever I do now, Jellybean, it's your fault.
Don't worry, Dino. I'm here.
Now you do what I say, or Dino will suffer. Ingenious. Yes, I think you'll be very impressed with my little plan. Comfy? There we go. Interesting. As the gasometer rises, the rope will slowly pull you under the water.
It's a long story.
Interesting. As the gasometer rises, the rope will slowly pull you under the water. Genius.
What a story. What are we going to do about the little Dino dude?
Right. This is serious. Gino said Block was clever. We'd better split up.
Fancy thinking this might be useful too. Some hope.
Oh, You must have been so worried for me.
Wish you drowned.
Now, we both know you don't mean that. Things are getting a bit difficult up here. I don't believe I've ever showed you my other premises.
What, a sewer?
Many a true word.
Something's happened here. But what?
And who knows how many. Look. Down here. Here. Yes. Risk it. That's my girl.
I'm singing in the rain. Just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling. I'm happy again. I mean, isn't this perfect?
So, the illustrious Harmony Parker, a pleasure to meet you.
Get out of here! He used the Queen's nose! He wished it could be destroyed!
I cannot tell a lie. I did. And now here you are, in the very best of all possible environments for a watery end.
Queen's nose!
This way!
Oh, I can't go on! You've got me!
Come to Daddy!
Don't you ever give up!
It's not in my nature. When I want something, I can't stop.
What do you really want?
I want everything!
The Queen's nose can give you everything!
I think I believe you.
You can have it! You want
this? You take it! No! Look out!
Let's find our way out of here.
Gone pink, Dad.
Oh. Morning.
Dad.
I'm speechless, son.
Yeah, but you just said something.
Shame we lost the Queen's nose, though.
Who says we did?
You mean all along I had an ordinary 50 pence piece?
Of course, I couldn't risk someone like Block getting his mitts on it, could I?
His mitts will be floating out into the North Sea within 2 hours.
Aunt Glenda won't be pleased, though. She wanted to catch him herself.
What's up? Glenda! Oh, no! No! No!
No!
What happened? She did it trying to save me.
Are you both okay?
Yes, but look!
Yeah. Shame, really. Nice hat. It'll be ruined now.
Gregory, don't be so heartless!
Don't you mean hatless, man?
Glenda didn't have a chance.
No, being tied up and slowly pulled under the water.
Must be agonizing. If you don't shut up, I'll just...
Your whole life flashing before you.
It's all your fault. You should have let me go.
Come with me.
Dino, are you all right?
Fine. How did you find her?
Easy.
Each time I pressed the remote control, I could hear this terrible screeching. Could it be Glenda's walkie-talkie? It seemed to come from the gasometers. I managed to track down Melody Nana. As we entered the area, the noise got louder and louder. realised the insect device you had mocked had saved Glenda's life.
Oh, good old Grogsy. And Block was swept away.
Only to reappear, he emerged from a sewer pipe over there. Actually, it's my very first arrest. Gave Mr. Grobbler a terrible fright, though. He was washing his socks in the canal at the time.
I thought it was a very rare form of eel. Sort of creature what lives in a snotty subterraneous. That's some S-U underground.
Oh, thanks for trying to save me.
All in a day's work. You could become my assistant.
You what?
Well, Melody and Harmony's parents will be back soon. You need somewhere to stay, and, well, you two could see each other, and I could keep an eye on you.
Do you mean it?
Well, just say yes before she changes her mind.
Yes!
Oh.
Yes. So my last wish did come true.
So that was it.
I made it before I went to Block. Oh, I didn't tell you, though.
Hey, my little milk and honey, the future's already behind us.
Where are you going?
Me and the animal are off to croon my tune for the loon.
Tell it like it is, sugar melon.
Little sister, keep fried. Don't let the bed bugs get you in the night. My man, I'm hungry for the road. Yo!
Yo,
yo.
Yo. That's love for you. Drives you stark raving bonkers.
10 wishes, use with C-A-R-E.
Right.
Bye-bye.
Boy, I've heard all about you.
Some of it may even be true.
I knew you'd come back one day. And you were right about the Queen's nose.
But you were wrong in thinking he'd used up all the wishes. The one with Block didn't count. It was the wrong coin.
Of course. So I still have a wish left.
I'm afraid not. I took the liberty, and these turned up.
Airline ticket.
For you, and you, and Melody, and Glenda, and me. We're all going to Australia. Family reunion.
Oh,
yes.
I wonder if that's the last we'll see of the Queen's nose.
Everything comes back, one way or another. Let's just wait and see, shall we?